Scientists are fleeing the United States because the Trump administration is too anti-science. I've seen more than just a few headlines about this in the past week, speaking of a brain drain. Today I have a summary of what happened and what it might mean for the future of science in the United States and elsewhere. On April 11th, budget documents leaked from the White House revealed President Trump's plan for sweeping cuts to science agencies. Those leaks were confirmed on May 2nd with a budget request coming from the White House. The budget request calls for a 37% cut at the National Institutes of Health. The National Science Foundation would be cut by more than 50%. NOAA, which researches and collects data on the ocean's weather and climate, would be slashed by 24%. NASA's science programs face a cut of more than 50% that it hit especially hard in astrophysics, where it'd likely mean the cancellation of the Nancy Grace Roman Space Telescope, which is under construction on budget and scheduled for launch in late 2026. In case the problem was it being named after a woman, maybe we can just rename it to Fancy Grace Roman Telescope. The Trump administration has reportedly already cancelled over $400 million in federal research to fight cancer and Parkinson's disease, and the NSF has stopped giving out new grants already. The planned budget cuts would have to be approved by Congress, but the message is pretty clear. These are not good times to be a scientist in the United States. The director of the National Science Foundation resigned, and so did the director of the National Institutes of Health. The latter also said that he and other scientists were not allowed to speak in any kind of scientific meeting or public setting.
It just became untenable. I was, as every other scientist in that circumstance, not allowed to speak in any kind of scientific meeting or public setting.
Some scientists have already drawn consequences and are leaving, like neuroscientist Danielle Beckman and the philosophy professor Jason Stanley. David Baker, professor for biochemistry at the University of Washington, who won a Nobel Prize last year, said in an interview with Chemistry World that 15 of his graduate students are looking for jobs outside of the USA, and several have already accepted jobs. According to the results of a Nature poll among scientists in the United States, 3/4 of the survey respondents are considering leaving the United States. This news was widely reported as saying that 3/4 of scientists want to leave the US. How seriously are we to take this? Are scientists really about to leave en masse, or is this like all the Americans that say they'll move to Canada on each election, but that never seems to happen? 3/4 seems a lot, but one has to take the Nature poll with a few grains of salt. For one thing, those were the replies by people who felt it worthwhile to reply to such a survey, so it's a biased sample. More importantly, we don't have a control group, because researchers, especially in the early stages of their career, are highly mobile and consider moving elsewhere all the time, Trump or not. So saying that they are considering leaving the country, even if they say it's in response to what the Trump administration has done, doesn't really mean much. That said, if Trump pulls through with his budget cuts, and I think that will most likely be the case, the job market for research positions in the United States is about to crash. People will leave simply because there are no jobs. Is this a good thing or a bad thing? The reactions from scientists that I've seen all think that this is a bad thing. I think it isn't as clear-cut. The just-departed NIH director asserted the NIH has a good return on investment.
Every dollar that NIH gave out in 2024 to a grant is estimated to have returned $2.46 just in a year. That's a pretty darn good return on investment.
The number comes from the 2023 fiscal report of the NIH, and it's not about returns on investment. It means that for every dollar that the NIH spends on, say, salary or lab equipment, other contributors, like, say, universities or private investors, spend $2.46. It tells you nothing about whether the research actually benefited the public besides making money go around. The reality is that most of taxpayer research almost certainly has a bad return on investment. This is because the entire science funding scheme has a tendency to overinvest into popular areas whether or not there is something interesting to research there. That the Trump administration is no longer willing to play this game is a very interesting development. Because a very foreseeable consequence is that the number of research publications with American affiliations will dramatically drop. I hope that this will induce a long necessary shift to better measures of research impact. That said, these cuts seem not very well thought through. They seem to be cutting everything that someone in the administration doesn't like and that might do more harm than good. But there's one thing to be said in Trump's favor. He gives us something to talk about. I read a lot of news to give you these summaries, and one of the best ways I've found to get a fast overview is with Ground News. Ground News is a news platform that collects and summarizes news which has been published all over the world. Not only do they collect all articles on the same story in one place and give you a quick summary, they also give you a lot of extra information that you don't find in the standard media. Take for example this recent story about Trump's cuts to the NIH. You can see right away that this was covered very little by the political right. Ground News also gives you a factuality rating, which in this case is very high. Here you can see who owns the media outlets, and it also tells you where the news has appeared. Ground News also has this great feature called Blind Spot. This tells you which news has been almost exclusively covered only by one side of the political spectrum. And of course I have a special offer for Vue, that's a 40% discount on the Vantage plan, which gives you access to all their features. All you need to do is use our link ground.news/Sabine or use the QR code so they'll know I sent you. The future's here already. You just need to know where to find it. Thanks for watching. See you tomorrow.